本视频所有操作由飞智手柄完成。
身为专业玩家，飞智手柄让我赢得更从容。
大家好，我是手柄哥小鱼，今天给大家带来三国题材 MOBA 类手游《梦三国》的视频介绍。下面我们直接进入比赛画面来介绍这个游戏。好，比赛开始了。这款游戏呢有四个技能，三个是主动释放技能，一个被动技能。我们主升一个选择，我们选择的是关羽啊。他的技能一技能是一个眩晕，晕住别人；二技能是一个跳斩，有一段一些位移；三技能也就是大招，旋风斩，就是可以持续几秒去原地旋转那种。不是原地旋转，可以控制移动的。这个游戏也是附送了召唤师技能，大家可以选择。说明哥选择的是治疗，上来就一级团了。这个，我们这个选手怎么好像两级啊？不欺负人吗？这个一血我们拿得到吗？我们能拿到。因为我们是主升的一技能，一级学的一技能，所以控制技能打起来、打架起来比较厉害啊。这个治疗术是可以回蓝回血。这款游戏是有四个技能，那个被动技能是什么意思呢？是大家可以看到，它会等会儿看一下啊。等会儿手柄哥学习以后，就是你普通攻击的时候，如果这个被动技能不在冷却时间，你的普通攻击会有一段 AOE 伤害，冷却 CD 好像是在四秒左右。那个这个游戏买装备也是不需要回城的，直接点击购买就行了。这款游戏我们飞智飞舞士叉九也是全面支持的啊。设备哥这是用飞舞士叉九，飞舞士什么黑武士叉九手柄啊，在玩这个梦三国手游。想购买的朋友可以去京东跟天猫搜索啊。来下路看看，下路没人啊，就队友。这款游戏目前只有3v3、1v1跟大乱斗，5v5的模式还没开放。等开放后，手柄哥会给大家每一一来介绍这个游戏5v5是怎么玩的，还有英雄方面的介绍。这款游戏的模型做上，总体来说啊，模型啊、技能各方面做的都很不错，而且打斗起来的顺畅度也是挺好的，还是挺有点小技巧的。这里有一个刘备，这家伙怎么移动速度这么快？我开了大招了，大家看，这就是我放的大招，就是学回旋转一样的。我靠，这里遇到人了，我没蓝，只能躲一下。草丛这里也是有草丛，这个游戏也是有草丛的，在草丛里别人是看不到你的。我现在没蓝，打不过别人，只有普攻。大家可以看到刚才那个像冲击波一样的技能就是我的被动。下面还有人射我，黄金的射我，快走。血量不健康了。这里提醒一下大家，这里看这上面有一些叶子的东西，是个可以吃的，就是回血回蓝的。一分钟刷新，大家可以看到。 还有在野区也是有这个刷 buff 的地方，这个刷 buff 还是随机的，好像有回血，有加速，有各种 buff。 我在这里蹲一下，等我们队友过来看看能不能杀一波，我技能马上好，大招子马上好，可对这就狂六级了，那干不过的味道。哦，果然他们伤害好高，伤害好高，快快溜快溜，让队友去买。哇，这黄忠已经一瞬间没血了，我不敢上。这里有个 buff 我吃一下啊，我回了半血哦，这个 buff 还挺给力的。打这个小兵啊，小兵要补最后一下会给100多块钱的那个金币，如果不补最后一下，你站在边上只会给你25块金币，所以说尽量补最后一下。我靠，刚才那个大招好帅啊，直接把我们的徐猪大块头给秒了。对面那个小乔的技能还是挺厉害的，我还小心一下，不要被他秒了。这游戏目前3v3来说还是可以，大家有兴趣可以去我们飞智大厅给我下载这个《牧三国》手游试一试啊。目前开放的英雄也是挺多的，都是三。
So this is the HTC Vive Pre, and it's the single best VR headset I've ever used for more than half an hour at a time.Technically, the Vive Pre is not the finished HTC Vive that's going to be coming out in April, but from everything we've seen, the hardware looks almost exactly the same. The downside of this is that the Pre definitely has kind of a 1980s jacking into cyberspace feel, even compared to other VR headsets. It's a little bit bulky, and it's got this large front-facing camera that should be able to show you the outside world when you hit a button or you go out of bounds of its trackers. Then there are these cables back here, which run down into an incredibly long cord that you're gonna have to steer clear of as you move around. But this cable's so long because the Vive actually gives you a lot of space to move around in. That's thanks to these two boxes around here called lighthouses, and what they do is spread lasers across a pretty large section of the floor, and then sensors on the headset and controllers will pick that up and calibrate exactly where you are in virtual space too. So okay, I've got my headphones plugged in. It's adjusted, so it's not going to give me a headache, which it will if it is even a little bit too tight. I'm going to put on these headphones. And I can actually see where these controllers are, because in the game they appear as a pair of hands. So this is Job Simulator, and it's mostly an excuse to throw things around with your controller. So this is where the Vive really comes into its own, because I'm actually walking around my office cubicle, eating some donuts, throwing some cups at things, photocopying some phones. And this obviously looks clumsy because that's kind of the joke of the game, but it's really precise, and so if I hit this button, it feels exactly what I might be doing with my hands. Normally I can get some really bad motion sickness in VR, if you're moving even a little bit in a game, but here I've barely even noticed it. That's mostly because when I walk here, it is one-to-one motion. I am walking in physical space and virtual space. So this is a game called Final Approach. You are landing airplanes and generally being a flight controller. So obviously I have a lot of space here, but not everybody's going to, and that's pretty okay for the Vive. A lot of the games, you really only need to be able to move a little bit in every direction, enough to land these little planes. It's even got a setting for just standing absolutely still. I'm just crashing all of these airplanes, crashing them horribly. So the controllers are obviously one of the best parts of the Vive because they really let you feel like you're interacting with space. This is really what sets a high-end headset apart from something like Google Cardboard, which is that you're able to create things, you're able to really affect the environment, you're able to actually get something that feels just a little like reality. I'm playing Tilt Brush right now, which is a 3D painting app. It's really detailed and really responsive, but it's also a sign that the controllers really could be designed a little bit better. They're a little bit heavy, and being able to hold them like remotes is great sometimes, but sometimes it also just feels kind of unnatural. It feels like I'm twisting my hand in weird directions to paint when I would be holding something like a pencil. Most of what you do with a little trackpad here and a trigger here, but there's also a home button right under that trackpad, which is a great idea. It's a pause menu, it's the way you launch games, but it's also right under my thumb, so when I'm doing something really exciting, look, there's the whole Steam menu. That's great. So like a lot of VR, the Vive asks you to just imagine your relationship with a computer as completely and fundamentally different. You're not really inputting commands. You're actually using yourself and putting yourself into some version of a game. It can feel really natural and can turn some things that are, you know, great but a little mundane in the real world into just amazing experiences. So I'm just here in ninja training, slashing fruit as one does. The thing that's really unique about the Vive is that your body feels the effects of the things that you're doing. That might not be great in the long run because it means that it kind of limits how much you can do with the experiences, but it's really fulfilling the promise of virtual reality. So I'm going to withhold judgment on this until the actual final version comes out, but everything I've seen so far has been fantastic. And the big question is going to be whether they can put enough good experiences on this that it's worth using in the long term. If nothing else, it's the first time I've spent 5 hours playing a 1 minute Fruit Ninja demo. So I'm optimistic.
我是永远爱你的，爱你我觉得值得，只是不能再爱了。不要追问谁对错，毕竟我们深爱过，有你陪的日子里我真的真的好快乐。你总是小心翼翼的，因为你怕我难过，而我却不能给你想要的结果，你永远是最好的。啦啦啦，说唱，我是个说唱先生。哎，你们犯想，我现在这样前面都是白的，会不会更亮？然后把这个拉过来就不亮了，对吧？不问众人对与错，毕竟我们深爱过，有你陪的日子里我真的好快乐。你总是小心翼翼的，因为你怕我难过，而我却不能给你想要的结果。一万个舍不得，不能回到从前了，爱你没有后悔过，只是应该结束了。一万个舍不得，因为你是爱你的，爱你我觉得值得，只是不能再爱了。一万个舍不得，不能回到从前了，爱你我没有后悔，只是应该结束了。一万个舍不得，我是永远爱你的，爱你我觉得值得，只是不能再爱了。分开了不代表不爱你了，我心里你永远是最好的。
谢谢，谢谢大家的竹子，谢谢大家的礼物，谢谢我们的陆强的七个饭团，谢谢你们。然后喜欢听歌的朋友可以点一下关注。你们孤单吗？是不是越长大越孤单呢？要不要主播每天晚上12点到4点陪你们过夜呢？那么就点关注吧。这个广告好像特别好。梦醒时分这首歌我会耶，谢谢我们的繁华。梦醒梦繁华，两个烤鱼，谢谢你，谢我浮云无忌，一个饭团，不对，是两个。